Hey guys, what's up? So I'm shooting this intro from my old school. It's Franklin in Berkeley. That's where I went to fourth grade, and that's when I started doing origami seriously. There was a classmate named Chu that really inspired me. Anyway, so the tutorial for today, I'm going to show you, well, this little thing, the fidget spinner, has become so popular among school-age kids, and so I've had so many requests to try to show you how to do this in origami. So, this is what I came up with. Here it is. It's an origami fidget spinner, and it can either spin like this, or like this, or you can put it on the end of a pencil, and it spins like this. Isn't that cool? Want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. All right, so for this fidget spinner, I used a 10-inch square of kami, and that's what I recommend using, but you could also fold it from a 6-inch square of kami. Then you'll end up with a smaller one. Still spins. I don't recommend using a square of printer paper, but if you have to, then, use a lighter grade, because if you use a heavier grade of printer paper cut square, then you'll end up with a kind of bulky model, and it might not spin so well. Spins okay though, like that, but it was really hard for me to fold. So I'm gonna show you from a 10 inch square of kami. Let's begin white side up and fold in half diagonally. Now, this really needs to be exact. Not like that, but right corner to corner, and hold the corners together and make that fold very sharply. Now let's rotate and let's fold in half in this direction. Once again, really exact. Okay, now let's unfold and rotate, and let's fold this corner to the midpoint. And let's fold the bottom edge to the top. And when you do that, try to hold the paper down so it doesn't slide up like that. Keep this corner in place. And make it line up perfectly there and there. And crease sharply. Now we're going to fold the bottom edge to the top edge again. And once again, hold it down nice and firmly against the table and make it exact. Line it up on the right. And crease and line it up on the left and crease. Okay, let's rotate. And now we're going to fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this crease. And when you do that, what you should do is hold right here really firmly. And then hold here really firmly so that the paper doesn't slide. And then fold it up right on that crease. And that way, the distortion of the paper is inside right here. You see it's crinkled, wrinkled a little bit there, but at least this stays pretty much undistorted. We want this flap to be clean, the same width the whole time that we're doing these folds. Okay, now we're going to do the same thing on this flap, but not in front. We're going to make it go behind. So let's turn over like that, and let's fold this flap up. And once again, hold firmly right here and hold firmly here. So I'm pinching and folding it up so that the two flaps align. And these two corners should touch and make the fold. Okay, now we're going to take this flap, and once again, holding it like this, we're going to fold it over so that this edge aligns with this edge. So hold on to it, pinch it, and fold it. So it's like that. And now we're going to take this flap and stick it behind this flap. Or you can take this flap and put it in front. Just switch the places. Like that. And you see how nicely it locks now. All right, now we're going to take this flap and we're going to fold it behind itself. So still in front of this flap. It goes like this. And when you do that, once again, let's hold on to it so that it doesn't distort. So hold, pinch it, and fold it. And when you do that, try to make it come to a point right here. That's not that important, but it looks better. Okay, so now it looks like this. Now let's fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this edge. And hold on to it. Notice I'm pinching it. Like that. Okay. And let's turn over and let's do the same thing with this flap. So fold it in front so that it aligns with this edge. And notice I'm pinching it. Okay. And now the two flaps are up against each other and they have pretty much the same width. That's good. Okay, now let's fold this flap to the left and fold it so that this edge aligns with this edge. And at this time, I'm no longer really holding on here because there's not a lot of layers on the flap anymore. So the paper's not going to get distorted so easily. Okay, and switch the places. So bring this flap in front. Like that. And let's fold this flap behind itself. Like that. And let's continue. Let's fold this flap up like this. And turn over and fold this flap up. Yeah, you see there's a tiny bit of distortion even when I did it. Okay, now let's fold this flap over so that this edge aligns with this edge. And stick it underneath. And let's turn over. And now we're going to fold this flap over so that this edge aligns with this edge. So just for now, fold all of the layers. Now you see that this flap sticks out and this flap sticks out. So let's unfold it and I'm going to show you how to make these flaps not stick out. Let's fold this corner to this point. Just fold it down so that it touches that point. And let's fold this corner to this point. And let's fold this triangle over itself, just like that. And now we're going to fold this flap over. Okay, so we fold it over, make that fold, and unfold. And now we're going to stick this whole bunch of paper into this pocket here. And try to open the topmost slot of this pocket. And let's insert this whole paper into that slot. Like that. And now make all of the creases nice and sharp. And here we have it. And what's cool about this is that it makes like a path that goes behind, around, in front, behind, around, in front. I just think it's kind of a cool like Celtic knot or something. So even like this, it works as a fidget spinner. You just blow on it. Hold it so that this is the bulky side, and the bulky side is like that, and blow right onto the bulky side. You might want to try to make this a little bit sharper. Now, if you find that these flaps are hitting your fingers, what you can do is just twist this end, this left end, a little bit like that, and twist the right end like that. And that way, you see, now when it goes through your hands, these points don't hit your fingers. So let's try it like this. It makes a cool noise. Okay, so that's one way to spin it. And you could also try to spin it like this. I'm gonna zoom out a little bit. Try to make it straight now. So it spins like that. And now we're going to stick it on a pin. So get a pin, preferably one that has a ball at the end of it, and stick the pin right through the middle. You don't need to puncture any holes because there's already a hole there. And even like this, you can just spin it and it'll spin like that. The trick is that you want to think about, this is the heavy side. So you want to swing the heavy side around, just like you're swinging a ball at the end of a string. It goes around, and then you just have to shake your hand at that frequency. So you can practice that with a pin, but it's actually even easier if you stick the pin into the eraser at the end of the pencil. You just stick it right in, try to stick it straight in and make it go all the way to the end. That way it'll be the sturdiest possible. And now you can use the whole pencil to shake. So once again, this is the heavy end. So this is what's going to be swinging around. So just think about that. So it's like that. And this could go on for a long time. So I'm not going to do that. Oh, you could also try to do it vertically, which is maybe a little bit more difficult. And maybe even up like that. That's a lot more difficult. And so, yeah, it spins like that, and it also spins like this. And it's also a pretty good flying flicker. Want to see how it flies? Let's try it. All right, so to flick this thing, you just want to hold it like this. You can either flick it like this, or you can try to throw it like a frisbee. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to flick it like this. Pretty good. All right, so I hope you guys enjoyed making this fidget spinner, and I hope you enjoy spinning it and flying it and showing it to your friends, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.